Hi, it's Jim Meskimen with another bunch of comments, really, on how to do impressions, how I do them, how you might take a look at improving your own impressions or learning new ones or just exploring this art form. And what I wanted to talk to you today is something that was echoed by some of the impressionists we talked to last week. If you haven't seen that video, I'd say you should watch that. It's a really cool video. Little bits of advice, and one thing several of them said was to look at the physicality of the person you're imitating, which of course is really, really key. And it's a funny thing that you know, people say to me a lot, "Wow, you know, I love to see your impressions because you facially embody, you know, you change your mask, and it starts to look like the person whoever I'm doing." And you know, which is certainly something that I have noticed as well, but it's not something I necessarily concentrate on too much, because it's all wrapped up for me into becoming that person. However, there is a lot to be said for studying the look and the physicality of the person you're imitating. For instance, last week, I think it was, I hadn't noticed really, I had to do a Tom Hanks impression, and Tom Hanks is an extremely difficult voice, I think, to do, because there's not a whole lot to hang your hat on. He doesn't have a very, he can have any accent he wants, but his own natural voice does not have a very strong accent. It's not extremely gravelly or gruff, and in fact, it sounds actually quite a bit like anybody's voice. That's me doing a little bit of Tom Hanks, which doesn't sound very remarkable. Plus, Jim Hanks can do it very well. But I noticed in studying some video footage of Tom Hanks, something I didn't notice before. I mean, I knew he had a really interesting melon. He's got quite an interestingly shaped head, and it creates a very interesting sound. He does not have a large nose. It's hard to determine what it is. But one thing I notice is that in interviews, you see his upper lip is not, it's mostly stationary. He's not like talking like this or enunciating a lot and showing his teeth a lot. Obviously, he does smile, but a lot of times his upper lip is pretty much clenched over his teeth, and that's just the way he's built. He's got an interesting curl of his mouth and the corners of his mouth, and while I can't really replicate that totally, I found that helped me adjust somewhat of the sound of his voice. Now, whether I brought it off successfully or not remains to be seen, and you can see it when we debut some new Impression Guys episodes later on in September. However, it just made it clear to me that, you know, there's something to be studied there. And I know Piot, my good friend Piot Michael, looks a lot at the facial characteristics, and so does Ross. And Piot has famously determined that Steve Buscemi, has got his teeth pulled back, and that gives him a characteristic sound. It gives a kind of an interesting sort of tinniness to his sound that you wouldn't be able to do if you weren't talking partially through your teeth. And, you know, that's just something you just get by observation. But it's also true that even, I think, the way one holds, you know, even the eyes change things a lot. And why, you know, I always scrunch up my eyes. Another impressionist to do George W. Bush, scrunch up his eyes. And while you do that, because that's how he looked, it also affects, I think it pulls the skin up in a different way. I don't know. But it when you take that and the kind of screwed up mouth that he has, it's sort of like smirky, I don't know what I'm about to say next sound, all that physicality actually changes the vocal dynamics of the impression. So it's pretty interesting. And I had a thought about vocal styles too, which is sort of related to this. You'll forgive me for going off on a little bit of a tangent, but I was thinking about how what I wanted to invite you to do, and what I will invite you to do, and what I do invite you to do, is to play with the sound of your voice and just play with your physical architecture. And coming in the back way with this comment, but for example, you can notice that certain people have a bit of an underbite, or the lower jaw comes forward. I'm thinking of Garrison Keillor, of course. And if you see Garrison Keillor's jaw comes jutting forward like this, his eyes are generally shut, looking down, and it affects the way that you hear him. Excuse me. Peter Dinklage, strangely enough, is another actor whose jaw really juts forward quite a bit. I'm turning to the side so you can see just how much I'm putting it forward, and in Game of Thrones, you can see it affects very much the way that his British accent comes out,
and the way in general that his tone is. Obviously, you know, if you start to play around with jutting it, your jaw back, that changes the sound a lot. That's a kind of for the older generation, a Mortimer Schnurd kind of character. Or Bullwinkle as well is one where you have to pull the jaw back. You know, it's just something that you sort of play with. And so I invite you to take your face and maybe stretch up one side. That's a Popeye thing, right? Or just sort of change the dynamics of your voice. You'll see that certain things will change if you tense up certain areas of your face. Talk in a way that you ordinarily wouldn't, where your face is generally in repose. In this case, I invite you to pick up a magazine or a book and read something with a different part of your face tensed up. And I think that'll be interesting for you. So that's what I invite you to do. That's what I want you to take a look at. Physicality, take your favorite star and really look at them. Look at them on video and go, wow, you know, their eyes are always like this. How does that affect the voice? Or, where's their jaw? Or, what are they doing with their lips and their teeth? Do you see the lower teeth a lot? Or do you see the upper teeth a lot? And that might give you a clue. Okay, hope that's helpful for you. Subscribe, comment, keep in touch, write if you get work.